Hi, I'm Sandra, and in this video I'll walk you through how to create and display georeferenced sections from array data in a database. You'll see how to create maps with a single section and maps with stacked 2D sections. We'll end by displaying these sections in the 3D viewer. When you open a project, you will notice that Section Tools is a standard menu in Oasis Montage. This database has section information stored in array channels. The XYZ channels are georeferenced, and the depth array channel delineates the depth information. At each depth, there is a corresponding data reading stored in the array channel. In this example, we are using resistivity data, but the array data could represent any other subsurface property. These depths indicate points at which the data is recorded. I want to draw your attention to two important details. First, there are 20 depth values for which we have either measured or calculated data. Second, all the depths are absolute depths on a Z-up axis. We will need this information shortly. The corresponding resistivity cell also has 20 elements in the array. The resistivity channel is identical to the resistivity loaded channel, but does not have depth information. I am interested in the three longer sections in the selected lines. These lines intersect, as can be seen when I plot them in the 3D viewer for context. First, I'll plot individual sections from the database for the selected lines. Next, I'll specify the data array and we'll pair this channel with the depth array that defines the points to which the resistivity readings belong. The negative depth box should be checked because, as you recall, when we looked at the depth cell earlier, we saw that the z-axis points up. A scale is always calculated by default, but I'll round it up to a nice even number. And I'll also set the vertical exaggeration to 2. Since I halved the exaggeration, I will also half the height of the output map. Geosoft's dynamic linking ensures that your database profile, 2D, and 3D maps are all linked to show the same cursor location. By clicking on different locations in one of the output maps, I can see the linking between the section, the index map, and the database. This makes it very easy to track how the data relate within the different views. Instead of plotting individual maps for each line, you also have the option to see the multiple sections stacked on one map. This time, let's select Stacked and select the resistivity loaded channel. Note that since the depth information is loaded, I no longer need to specify it separately, but I will need to provide the DEM for the topographic surface from which the section hangs. I can further customize the surrounds by adding a title block and annotating the relative length along the bottom of each section. Data linking connects the cursor location in the section, plan view, database, and the 3D viewer. Since the data and output section grids are georeferenced, they can easily be added to the 3D viewer. All Geosoft applications support georeferenced sections, allowing you to share either the section grids, maps, or the 3DV file. So now you've seen how you can quickly plot individual and stacked sections in 2D maps and the 3D viewer.